essentially what I see in my orchard, and I don't know if this is very common, that the cherry trees grow like crazy. They grow really quickly. But some of the apple trees, oh my gosh, you could wait forever to get a harvest from those trees. Is that a generalization or is it actually accurate?
It's a good generalization. Cherries grow more than apples in general in a given season, as well as peaches. Peaches are very rapidly growing. When you look at the actual amount of growth in a single year on a peach tree, it can be about a meter long in shoot growth compared to an apple might be half a meter. So the genetics of the species play a big role, but also there's a lot of other factors that can affect the growth of each species. And for example, the climate or the soil can have a huge impact.
One thing that I've heard, and I don't know if it's true, that Honeycrisp apples, which are kind of notoriously finicky and hard to grow, that they are incredibly slow. I've read online that Honeycrisp apples can take 7 years to produce their first harvest. Is that true?
Partly true. Honeycrisp tree, we group, in terms of apples, we group them into weak or vigorous or moderate vigorous varieties. The genetics of the cultivar play a big role in how quickly they grow. But there's something else that we refer to as precocity, and that is how quickly the tree begins to bear fruit. And actually, Honeycrisp are very weak growers, but they're extremely precocious. So they'll start to flower the second year of after planting and begin to produce fruit if you let them. Sometimes that's not a good plan, though, because it can result in the tree growing slowly and then becoming runted over time or small.
So you introduced two interesting terms that I've seen a lot of. And sometimes when you go to a fruit tree nursery, they will talk about vigor and they will talk about precocity or precociousness. I don't know what's the right way to say it. What's the difference between the two?
Tree vigor refers to the vegetative growth. How much the tree shoots grow, leaf growth, etc. Precociousness or precocity relates to the flowering and amount of fruit that grows, and in particular, how quickly it's produced after the tree is planted.
For us, for home growers as well, or for small scale growers, you can research and learn a lot about rootstock and the role that the rootstock plays in how big your tree is going to get, but also how quickly it's going to grow, how resistant it is to disease. Can you talk to me about a little bit about rootstock and what role that plays in this equation?
When you buy a modern tree from the nursery, you're usually buying a tree that has two parts to it. One is the variety, the apple or fruit that you want. So for example, in Ontario, some of the popular apple varieties are Honeycrisp, Empire, Macintosh, Gold Delicious, etc. So that is the top part of the tree, but there's actually a different root system and it's genetically different. And that's called the rootstock. And the rootstock is used for a number of reasons, but primarily to dwarf the tree or make the tree smaller.
So I put out on Facebook, I said, folks, you know, what are the cultivars that grow fastest for you? I've got a few interesting comments. I want to read them to you, John. This one is from Lisa in New Hampshire. She writes, my Red Haven peach produced the fastest and most fruit. I have several varieties of peaches, pears, and apples. So that's interesting. So she's growing lots of different things on one site, but the Red Haven beats everything. Does that say anything to you or is that an accident?
Certainly when you could, you know, that's my experience too. We grow at Red Haven at our research station. And it's peaches in general are very vigorous. And it's also important to add that not all fruit tree species like peaches and peaches and more specifically, but we don't have a lot of size controlling rootstocks for the peaches. So generally they grow a lot more than apples, where we have a huge range of rootstocks that provide size control. So I would certainly concur with your listener there from New Hampshire, where Redhaven grows very, very quickly and vigorously.
That makes sense. So basically, now I understand that what you're saying is these size control rootstocks, because they're designed to make your tree smaller, they may also be designed to get your tree to grow a little slower.
Yeah, that's the primary function, is to offer size control. But more and more important, it's also to offer disease resistance and in our climate, cold hardiness, where we're at the normal limit. So we want to make sure the tree can survive the cold winters that we experience here in southern Ontario.
Okay, this is from Eric. Good afternoon. Eric from Hamilton, New Jersey here. For apples, we bend the branches down slightly below horizontal. And for pear, we bend the branches down to horizontal. This supposedly triggers the hormones of the tree to produce fruit rather than produce wood. This is quite contrary to the crotch angles that are taught in the US. Wow, Eric, thank you. What a great question. John, what do you say? Can you explain what his question is?
Yes, the branch, we call this training of the tree training. And in modern orchards, it's branch bending is a technique to promote flowering and therefore fruiting. So when the tree is growing, when the tree or the shoot is growing vertical, it has a tendency to be vegetative. In other words, grow leaves and compete with the main leader of the tree. If we want to switch it into growing fruit, we can do that by bending it, and you bend it and tie it down with various techniques. So you can use weights or string, spreaders. There's various ways, there's no right or wrong way. And that what that does is it changes the apical dominance of the tree. Branch bending is a great technique to encourage the tree into fruiting earlier.